All right, welcome back. I'm Jake Baxter from Jake Baxter Training. Part two of our snatch series, and we're going to look at the high hang and the hang snatch. So both of these will lead into each other, and it's going to make it easier for you to break down and learn this movement. So we pick the bar up exactly the same grip as our overhead squat and snatch balance series. So again, it should be sitting at the crease of your hips, knuckles facing down. Today we're going to start with a tall muscle snatch. Legs are locked out, butt squeezed, and this is going to look at how your arms move to get the bar into the overhead position. So from here, keep your knuckles down for as long as you can, pull the elbows high and wide, and then press at the very end. When you do this, that bar should be directly over your upper back, head should be slightly in front, and the arm should be pressing high like that. This is how our arms are gonna move. And if we think back to the snatch balance, our legs are gonna move the same way. So they start underneath our hips. We dip down, keeping our torso upright, feet equally balanced between the toes and the heels. And from there, you're gonna jump and land in the deepest squat position you can get into, then stand up. Now the arms move just like that tall muscle snatch, but with a little bit more speed. So we dip down, bar pressed into the hips. You jump and land, pull the elbows towards the ceiling, pause in that squat, then stand back up. If we look from the side, we start with the bar at our hips, press it in against the hips, dip down there, chest is on top of the bar, drive and land into that position. If you struggle to get into the deep squat with speed, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna dip, land where you're comfortable, then squat down into your deepest position and stand up that way. To get better at that, you can start high, always go down into the squat, and gradually try to catch lower and lower and lower until you're in the full squat. That's your high hang snatch. Moving this forward, we're gonna look at how we go from the top of your knees back to that position at your hips. So the power position is something we always wanna return to. So, taking the bar, we're starting here. This is your hang position. We dip, and from here, you send your hips backwards, but keep your hips quite high, so we feel a little bit of a stretch in the back of your legs. From the side, the arms should be relaxed and slightly over the top of the bar with the shoulders and chest, not behind it. So we go from here, we lean forward like that. And the goal from this position is to get it back to that power position to finish vertically. So if you watch, we're gonna do it slowly to start. Dip down, come forward till you find that stretch. And then as you come up, there into your hips, and then you can complete your snatch. So from a direct side angle, I'm gonna speed it up this time. You dip, lean forward, and then the bar and the hips come in to meet. You finish tall and down into your catch. One common error when you're doing this is that you'll start to drift back too early. That's gonna put you way behind the bar and send the bar out. What we wanna try and do is finish nice and tall like that. And with the elbows coming high, as I go down into your catch position. Give that a go. Work from going the high hang or the power position to the hang, and you can link the two together. So do one high hang, one hang, and try to replicate the exact same positions on the way up. And again, like the overhead squat and snatch balance, only go as heavy as you can while maintaining speed and maintaining the form. And then that will be learning the hang snatch. The next part of the series is bringing it into the full lift.